remarkable humanitarian work and for the incredible human being she is with the 2016 Israeli Film Festival Career Achievement.
In the 20 years that Marty has represented me, he has gone from being my lawyer, and let me tell you, that's some lawyer. You really only have to CC Marty, and that's just about it, to being my friend, to being, well, Marty, since my dad passed away, Marty is often the person that I go to for paternal advice. Because Marty is, if you ever met his daughters, you would know, one of the greatest parents and one of the finest fathers I've ever met. So thank you. I'm pretty sure his daughter wrote those jokes. It is such an honor for me to be a kid from a small town in Pennsylvania, particularly on a day such as today when the people from small town across America have spoken in a way that both surprised and didn't surprise me. Because I come from a very working class, blue collar background, and I still have family that lives in this environment. To have come from such an unlikely place to be in this very unlikely place. My film career has always been so up and down because I came here with a very blue-collar attitude. I didn't just pick and choose all of the plum roles because I felt that what I should do was work. So I picked working. I believed my job was to work. I didn't always pick the best parts. I picked parts. I picked learning. I picked growing. Because my dad worked in a factory, and where I grew up, we worked. We pushed up our sleeves and we went to work. So as my career grew and my work turned into stardom, and I became remarkably famous in a way that women in my generation and generations near to me were very rarely ever touched with this kind of remarkable fame. It was a maddening kind of fame. Well, at first it was fantastic. I thought, oh my God, they know. And then, of course, I realized, this is just crazy. And what am I going to do with this kind of maddening fame? And I read this great book about fame and the history of fame throughout time and what fame really means. And in fact, to me, it didn't really mean that much unless it was applied to something. To me, I needed to apply it to human rights. And about the time that I came to this realization, we were at the Cannes Film Festival, and we had closed the film festival with The Quickly Dead. And Elizabeth Taylor couldn't come to Amphoe that year, and I was asked if I could take over for her that year. Of course, I was terrified. I mean, those are some pretty big shoes to fill. And I had no idea what to do, except that I had, for the Make-A-Wish Foundation, made a wish to a young girl who was dying of AIDS, who was about 12, and I had spent the day with her. And that was, I can say, longer than this evening. I learned a lot that night, and then I was asked if I would take over Elizabeth's position at Amphoe, which I did. With the agreement that I would do it for 3 years. And after 3 years, I realized that that was really not going to do it. It's been 21 years now, and we've made enormous strides. And in those 21 years, I've also done Planet Hope with my sister, as you read about, and a variety of other things. What I have learned, though, is that it's not about AIDS. It's about seeing the person sitting next to you and seeing them fairly, squarely, and as they actually are, not as you wish them to be, and helping them with what they need and when they need it. I think about that a lot today because 50% of our country wanted something very different than the other 50% of our country, and we are a grossly divided nation. And the only thing that will provide unity for us, and that us is a global unity because we still are viewed as the leaders of a free world. The only thing that will provide unity for us is if we continue to work to see our fellow man for who they are and for what they need. Whether we agree or disagree, we must still see one another clearly, openly, and with love in our hearts. That's matured me greatly in the pursuit of my career, in the pursuit of my philanthropical ideals, and in the pursuit of the joy of my life. And it has led me to understand that happiness is a discipline, because it is. Did I vote for Donald Trump? I did not. Do I respect the office of the presidency? I do. Will I do my very best to work with our next president to continue the goals and the ideals that I have for human rights? I will. I urge you to do the same because we in this town show great force in how we make our films and how we influence the world. We are the second largest export of this nation. Arts. Whether they are funded or not, we are powerful. And what we say with what we do matters. And it matters globally. And it has impact. It has meaning. And we touch each other. We touch each other in Israel. Shimon taught me a lot. The time that I got to sit with him, the time he put his hands on my shoulders, the times he taught me and mentored me. I am one lucky woman. I am grateful. Grateful for the mentors that I have had. I'm grateful that you honor me with this. And I know that he would want me to tell you to move forward in peace, move forward in love, move forward in humor, in dignity, in your creativity. Keep going. Give me a couple of jobs. And be, above all, your very best. Thank you very much for being here.